Thanks to PassFabs for sponsoring this video and supporting my channel. Hey, it's me. Haven't uploaded in quite a while, in fact, 3 weeks. Well, because this happened. Yikes! Anyway, in this video, I'll show you how you can jailbreak iOS 14.5 and that too by using a Windows PC. And I'll break down exactly what you need to do so that you can properly jailbreak your device to get all these cool tweaks for free. But real quick, I just got one favor to ask of you. It would mean the world to me if you can hit the like button for the YouTube algorithm. That's it. And something as simple as hitting the like button helps YouTube in recommending my videos to a wider audience. Well, that said, let's quickly jump into it. Alrighty, the very first thing you need to do is to go ahead and open a browser of your choice. I'm using Firefox, but as long as you're using something like Google Chrome or Microsoft Edge, it doesn't really matter. Now, all you have to do is to go ahead and go to the link down in the description below. It will be the second link or the third link, but it will be something like buttondown.email/idevice/. Now, real quick, just put in your email over here and click on the subscribe button and you'll instantly gain access to all the downloads required to perform this tutorial for free. By the way, clicking on the subscribe button will actually roll you in my newsletter where I basically share jailbreak updates, Apple news, and some wallpapers that you'll enjoy. Because doing these videos takes a lot of time, and as soon as a jailbreak update comes out, if you want to stay on top with the jailbreak news, well, within a few seconds, I'll quickly send out emails that, hey friends, this jailbreak is out. Hey friends, don't update to this iOS version or anything like that. Well, subscribing is the best thing you can do to A, gain access to all the downloads, B, stay on top with the jailbreak news. Just click on the big download button and the download will start. Now, once you have downloaded it, just go ahead and go to the location where it's downloaded and you have to right click on it and click on extract all. Again, click on extract and this will basically extract the zip file. If you have used your Windows PC or you're familiar with how these things work, you already know how to extract a file and how easy it is. Now we'll close out this new folder window that opened and you'll see this extracted zip file over here. These are important instructions and if you're watching this video, you probably don't need to look at it because I'm gonna explain you every single thing so that you can easily jailbreak your device. So we're gonna get rid of that one. Now you see, there are two files here and a folder. All you have to do is to go ahead and open the smaller file. At this stage, all you have to do is to go ahead and bring a thumb drive of your choice. 4 GB or more will be sufficient. This here is a SanDisk pendrive and I'll quickly plug it in my PC. Yeah, that's all you have to do. It's very easy. Anyone can do it. PassFab. With their iPhone unlocker tool, you can easily remove Apple ID on iPhone and iPad. It also offers a one-click bypass for locked, disabled, broken screen devices. Click the first link in the description to learn more. Relaunch Rufus software and click on the big select button. Select that disk image file which was 223 megabytes. Now you have to click on open and click on start. I'll explain what's going on here in a bit, but just simply do it. Now as you can see, it's writing, formatting your pen drive and doing its thing. Until then, I'll explain what we just did over here. Now, in short, all we did was that we downloaded the zip file, we extracted it. Pretty simple. Once we extracted that zip file, we got two files and one folder. We opened the smaller file, which was an application, was around 1 megabyte, and then we selected our pen drive in that 1 megabyte software, and we clicked on the big select button, and then we selected the ISO file here in Rufus software. It's as easy as that. That's all you have to do. The next thing, you can launch Checkrain and I'll tell you how you can do that to jailbreak your shiny new iPhone or it's an old iPhone or whatever it is, but it's as easy as that. Yeah, I know Checkrain like doesn't work on Windows, but this is how you can do it. Again, all we did was that we extracted that file, we opened Rufus software, we selected this ISO file in Rufus software and then we clicked on start. Pretty darn easy. Now it's gonna take a little bit depending upon the speed of your computer and all you have to do is just wait. Like it usually takes around 2 to 3 minutes, but as you can see, it's ready. Now once it's done, simply shut down your PC.
Hey, sorry for the interruption and bad audio quality because I'm not in my studio. I'll make this real quick. The thing is, many people watch my videos, like hundreds of thousands, but they straight up don't comment in the comment section down below if these things work for them. Please leave a comment so that other people can know these things actually work.
Once you shut down your PC, it's completely powered off. It's like a black screen. Turn on your PC while rapidly pressing a key to enter in one-time boot menu. Now, it's going in one-time boot menu, but how on earth you know which is the key to enter in one-time boot menu for your laptop? I'll link a full guide down in the description below. It's a PDF file, and that will show you your laptop name and then which key you can use to enter in one-time boot menu. For me, it's F12, but for you, it will be something like F5, F6, F8, or anything like that. Basically, you can just go ahead and try like 10 times to see which key works for you, or you can just go ahead and refer to that PDF file, which will be down in the description below. And you have to select the name of your pendrive and hit on enter. It's gonna take some time and you'll see these booting screens or anything like that. Now, at this stage, once again, I'll quickly show you. This here is an iPhone 7 running on iOS 14.5. Cool. Now, as you can see, Checkrain is live. Everything seems to work fine now. I'll just quickly go ahead and drop white balance a bit. Yeah, as you can see, Checkrain is live on my Windows machine and everything seems to work perfectly fine. Now, at this stage, all you have to do is to go ahead and grab a high quality lightning cable. Make sure it's a good one, or just use one that came with your iPhone. Connect your PC to your iPhone, and this is very important, and if you don't do this step right now, it will seriously, like, just click on trust. It's as simple as that, but many people just don't do it, and then they say in comments that, hey, this Jailbreak doesn't work, what are you doing? Well, you have to click on trust. Then click on start, click on next, and I'll just quickly bring my phone over here, and it's entering in recovery mode. Now again, I'm saying nothing is going to happen to your device. The most that can happen is that your device will simply boot back to iOS and the jailbreak will not go through. At that time, you can just try to re-jailbreak your iPhone. Now on your screen, you'll see some instructions. Like for me, it says you have to hold the side button and the power button for 10 seconds, and after 5 seconds you have to release the power button, or it will be something different for you depending upon which iPhone you have. I'll click on start and I'll press both volume down and side button, and I'll release the side button, but still I'll keep pressing the volume down button. And now it's doing its thing. It's checking if the device is ready and it's installing the jailbreak onto your iPhone. This might take like 10 to 15 seconds, but you have to wait for a little bit to ensure that your device gets jailbroken. And this, my friends, is the coolest thing I've ever seen on an iPhone. It looks so darn fancy. So you can just go ahead and show it to your friends or anything like that if you're interested in that sort of stuff. But now your device is booting. We'll enter in the password and it says it's all done. But there is no Checkra1n icon for us to install Cydia. So we'll wait for the Checkra1n icon to appear, and maybe we'll try going into general. Yeah, as you can see, done. It's basically it. Make sure your device is connected to an active internet connection. Open Checkra1n loader and click on install Cydia. It's gonna download base system. It's gonna download Cydia. It's gonna install Cydia, and it will automatically quit the Checkra1n loader app so that you can use Cydia to enjoy all the things, install tweaks, do so many fun things with your iPhone, and seems like everything worked perfectly fine. Now, one little thing I just didn't mention is that you have to click on quit and then you have to type in reboot to make sure your Windows PC quits Checkra1n and boots back into Windows, because you want that. Cool. Now I'll just shut it down. Either way, that's been it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, drop a like, subscribe to the channel, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.